The darkest moment in any hero's tale usually comes just when things are finally falling into place. Our unlikely heroes discovered the unfinished, top-secret project of the doomed Atlas Corporation, the Gortis robot. Searching for the robot's missing components made the dream of the vault seem closer than ever, even though the former middle manager was still haunted by the demented ghost of Hyperion past.
Destroy that body while I'm still young.
Unfortunately, any dream can quickly turn into a nightmare, and this nightmare's name was Valerie. Fortunately, Valerie's killing spree was interrupted when another dangerous adversary was suddenly revealed as a powerful ally. Now, supported by a legendary gladiator, their search continued through the icy wastes of the Borderlands to a forgotten Garden of Eden. There, they found another piece of the Gortis robot, as well as the last surviving man on the gladiator's murder bucket list. As she prepared to take revenge, the con artist intervened. That was the moment that Valerie chose to strike. Outgunned and outmaneuvered, the con artist and salaryman were forced to surrender. Now, they were working for Valerie, and their first job was likely to be their last.
Shelter. Looks like we're in for some showers.
Oh, awesome. Yeah, let's do that. Can't wait.
Are you thinking? It looks like you're thinking.
That suit he's wearing. It looks familiar, but I can't place it.
Yeah, I hear you. What the hell is this guy getting out of all this? I can't figure it out. Endless march down memory lane. There's gotta be a reason for it.
He wants a vault. Why else would he be collecting Gortis pieces? He's just like every idiot on Pandora looking to strike it rich.
Aren't you kind of, you know, vault hunting now?
Are you calling me an idiot?
Yeah, it's what I did there. Yeah. I feel like we should do something. If we get to those hills, maybe we could lose him.
Yes.
I don't know. What's he gonna do, huh? Shoot us both? I seriously doubt that.
Don't be stupid. He has a gun.
So? He clearly needs us for something. If he wanted to shoot us, he already would have.
I think all those shots to the head are taking their toll.
That hasn't helped. I'm making a break for it. And you should too. Remember, zigzag when you run, okay? Head up. Makes you harder to hit.
That sounds stupid.
It's not stupid. It's genius. All right, going on three. One. Two. Three, go!
That's a weird way to run.
He's zigzagging. It apparently makes him harder to hit.
Of course.
What the hell was that?
I don't know.
Meteor shower, get to the shelter.
What's that?
This again.
Clearly, I can't trust you two.
But I didn't even run.
And that's why you're still conscious. So, you just gave away Gortis.
She was taken.
And you were stuck under Valerie's gun.
It was a rocket launcher, okay? It was massive. Even for her.
Vaughn?
on!
Shut up.
Hey!
Stop it, please!
Not so rough.
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry, boss. The nerd is gone. Some old dude with crazy hair ran off with it.
That's okay. We've got what's important. There, there, little one. No need to be upset.
I'll answer your questions. Please, just promise that you won't hurt anyone.
Of course, dear. I don't want to hurt anyone that's being cooperative.
Gordis, just tell her what you know.
Now, tell me about the Vault of the Traveler.
The Vault of the Traveler teleports all over the universe, only staying in one spot for a few minutes before blinking away. But once I have my last piece, the beacon that's up on Helios, I can summon the vault and hold it here. Then you collect treasure or something.
What does the beacon look like?
I don't know. But I'll know it when I see it. That's what happened with the last piece.
Well, that's some exciting news. Thank you, Gordis.
You're welcome. Can I get away from you now?
Of course. Look at you, Fiona. Just so angry. Is this about Athena? You're feeling guilty. That's what.
Leave her alone!
You can't blame yourself.
Where did they take Athena?
It seems Lilith and the Crimson Raiders have some questions for her.
For what?
Your friend has a long list of heinous things she has to answer for. Now listen up. Under normal circumstances, your rotting corpses would already be getting torn apart by skags right now. But these are not normal circumstances. And with that last piece being on Helios, I can't think of a better crew than a pair of Pandoran con artists and a Hyperion stooge to figure out a way to get it for me. What do you say? And I'll give you a hint. The only right answer is yes.
You don't buy any of this bullshit, Fiona.
This is not a negotiation.
Yeah, okay, we'll get you the piece.
Oh, come on.
Well, that's just lovely. And here I thought I was going to have to stab someone. Son.
Yeah?
Be a dear and help them come up with a plan.
Yes, ma'am. Let's get cracking.
I'm telling you, it's not possible. We can't do this.
That's not an option.
Neither is getting ourselves killed.
One way or another, we're gonna figure out how to pull this off.
Okay, let's start with how we're gonna get there.
Well, this isn't
okay,
the first time we've
okay,
had to get
come on.
We'll find
I
a
I know what we have to do.
Thank you.
All right, guys, it boils down to this. Somehow we've got to get to Helios, infiltrate Hyperion, and steal Gordis's vault beacon. Sorry, that was breakfast. Sorry. Without getting ourselves killed.
No shit, moron.
I just said that like 30 seconds ago.
Everyone knows what we have to do. We're just trying to figure out how to do it.
Okay, okay.
If you stop being so negative, maybe we
How's
can make
tum-tum
some progress.
There, buddy? That'll teach you to hit the taco truck.
Right now, I don't see how that's gonna
wow.
happen.
Wow, you
we'll
got the magic,
together,
kid. They should bottle the
so
stuff.
Many things
call it
go
weak
wrong.
Sauce.
And that's why we have to drill down
no, I'm
every
sure there's,
aspect
there's
of the mission.
In there
so
somewhere. We just gotta keep
I'm
looking.
The one forcing us to go on a
Actually,
suicide
I could use your help.
Yeah, of course you could.
Great. Real helpful.
Is that a yes or no?
What? You think old Jack would leave his meat buddy hanging?
We don't have a choice.
I
Valerie's kind of
honestly
got
don't
corner
know how to answer that.
You don't think I know that?
Then maybe
all right,
try
okay,
coming
I know
up with
we've
a few
had
solutions.
Our differences,
okay,
and I'll admit I can
go.
Get pretty grouchy when I don't get my
you know
own
we
way.
Can't do that.
To maximize
Fine,
our
what's
chances,
your solution, then?
I'm ready to bury the
I don't know. But I know
it's a metaphorical hatchet, especially because I know I don't really have any hands right now. Which is a real bitch, I tell you what.
You know, I know you love hearing yourself yammer on, but just spit it out, will you?
Whoa. Do I seriously talk too much, Reese? I'm sorry, man. And no one's ever told me the truth before. Thank you. Thanks for your honesty. I really appreciate it, man.
You're welcome.
Yeah, what I'm saying is this. I got your beacon somewhere in my office. Get in there, and it's mission accomplished, baby.
I just don't see how we're gonna do this.
You don't get that beacon. You're all as good as dead.
You're not helping.
Oh, great. Captain Obvious wants to speak.
I believe I have some information that is relevant to your interests. The beacon is in Handsome Jack's office.
You pulled that out of your ass.
Well, check it out, smart guy. Run it by Gordis.
Fine. Hey, put the little robot on. Listen, you got access to a map of Helios?
I do.
See if you can focus your scan for the beacon in Handsome Jack's old office.
Beacon detected! We go, winner! I'm sending Reed the location data now.
Well, let's see what we have here. Enhance?
Oh, so you can say it.
You're shitting me.
I wouldn't know how.
That whole sector must be crawling with guards.
Hey, give me one reason why you think we could possibly break in.
Man, how many people you gotta kill to get an office like that?
Billions. And I think that's rounding down on Jack's murder count. You better believe that place is under lock and key and laser booby trap.
I get that you're scared. Okay, I am too, but working together, I think we have a shot.
Great. Sign me up.
I don't know how we're gonna get through this.
Teamwork. That's how.
Then you better have a damn good plan.
Oh. It's killer.
Behold! Helios!
Okay. Now how do we get there?
Oh, well, Helios is in space, so we need a spaceship, obviously.
Well, we don't exactly have one lying around.
Hey, what about Scooter? He said we could call him anytime.
Well, you got yourself a rocket man, miss.
And then it's off to Helios.
Pandora, we have liftoff.
Before we dock, I'll tell Yvette we've arrived. She'll help us.
Why not call her now?
Now, the less she knows, the safer she is. Yvette, we're back.
Awesome, Reese. You're a hero. I'll tell the guards to let you through.
At ease, soldier. Then I'll disable the security system. Yeah, it'll work. Fiona, you'll take Sasha and Gordis and go to the hub of heroism. Now, up on Helios, Jack's office is a museum. Hallowed ground. Not even Vasquez had access. Looks like the only sure access is the VIP tour.
Meet your new tour guides. From there, we'll get into Jack's office, where I'll...
Hang on. You'll need me for that, obviously. Once inside, Gordis will ID the piece.
Wow! This place is huge! This way, please!
And to the victors go the spoils. Told you. Killer plan.
Wait a minute. How are you gonna pull any of this off? Hyperion wants you dead.
Then I better go as someone else. And for the grand finale, I'll digistruct a vast skies.
But Hyperion's gonna want proof that Reese is dead.
We'll use Vasquez's body. They'll never know the difference.
This could actually maybe work.
So, I guess all that's left is pitching the plan to Valerie.
She'll go for it.
And getting me to Old Haven.
And I'll go to Scooter's.
Wait a second.
Hmm?
So, how did you figure out the pieces in Jack's office?
Don't tell him, Princess! You'll sabotage the whole freaking mission!
It just came out of nowhere.
Don't do it! You'll only make things way worse.
Okay, team, prepare to have your minds blown. Handsome Jack is in my head.
God, but damn it!
Just allow me to explain, okay? When I plugged Nakayama's ID drive into my head port, I kind of accidentally uploaded an AI version of Jack into my brain. But it's cool. It's cool. I've got everything under control. Kind of.
What? You had that murdering son of a bitch in your head all this time, and you didn't tell us? You asshole.
And we thought August was a prick.
Okay. If Jack's really in there, I want to talk to him. You know, just give him a piece of my mind.
Yeah, that's not happening.
But he'll only talk to me.
Oh, how convenient.
Well, that went over well. Even your oddly ripped moron sidekick took it better. Anyway, you know how it goes. Snitches get stitches. I just made that up. It's clever.
So wait, when you fell off that balcony back there, that was Jack?
And here I thought of you as a friend.
I'm not one to say I told you so, but, I told you so. Oh, good times, huh? Have fun cleaning up your mess!
I'm sorry, all right? I should have mentioned it earlier.
Yeah, you think?
What is wrong with you?
I get it. I messed up.
Let's just say, for argument's sake, that you didn't mean to be a lying scumbag, and that you understand that you should have shared what is an incredibly vital piece of information.
So far, so good, I guess.
Even if we could somehow trust you again,
how can we trust Jack? No more lies.
You need to level with us from here on out.
No. Guess what? Frankly, no one knows Hyperion better than Jack.
So, you think he'd be helpful?
I think we'd be crazy to go in without him.
Without who?
All right. Valerie signed off on the plan. Reese is going with Finch and Kroger. The rest of us are off to Hollow Point to get this thing spacey. Let's get to work.
August, watch Gordas.
I'll miss you!
Just hurry up. I don't like being alone with this thing.
But I like you so much.
No.
Hey, have you got a plan for what to say to Scooter? Because he screwed him out of a lot of money for those caravan repairs. He could be angry. And I've heard stuff about what he did to the Safford clan. He's a pretty jolly guy for someone who just buried another man alive.
Just be honest. He likes us, and he's a decent guy.
Yeah. I mean, he'll probably jump at the chance to build something cool, right?
Ha! Yes, I live and breathe it, but I'm Fiona, looking as fresh in her new duds as any gentlelady I ever seen. Come to see your old sponsor, huh? How go the races? I know you sure like going fast, ha ha. Wait, no, not like you're a fast woman or, oh shoot, like racing's just in your veins, is all I'm saying. I'll shut up.
Oh, hey, so, we lied about being racers. We were only in that one death rally by accident. We just really needed repairs. Like, life or death stuff. Sorry.
Oh no, I am so surprised. Come on, girl, I knew you wasn't racers, but you look like a couple of good-natured gals, and I never turned down an opportunity to help a couple ladies, especially when I got a crush on one of them, and I will not say who that is, no matter what. Fiona, shoot! What can I do you for? Not saying that I want to do you or nothing, no. Well, not that I'm saying I wouldn't, either. Would one of you, like, open your mouths and make with the wording so I can shut mine? I mean, my uncle always said, never open your mouth.
Scooter, we are going to space.
What? I love space! It's like my fourth favorite thing, behind tacos, trucks, and heavy eye contact. That all sounds great. Only problem is funding.
No, don't worry about it. Valerie will pay for whatever we need to get to Helios, get the Gordas piece, and get out.
I understood exactly half those words. Let's do it. Oh, wait, when I said that there was only one problem, I meant that there were two. Because look, I know a lot about cars and I know a lot about engines, but rockets are right out of my purview. My business partner knows rockets like you wouldn't believe, but she's a little out of sorts.
Oh, no.
Jenny's been like that since she heard about some big vault hunter fight what happened out in the tundra. Athena ain't checked in for a while. She put two and two together. She ain't in much of a mood to do rocket stuff.
Maybe you should talk to Orphee. You're the last one who saw Athena, right?
Yeah. Hi, Janie.
Hi, Hat Girl. Athena's not the type to leave just for some random delivery job. She lied, and you covered her ass.
I
really wanted to believe her. I did. But she forgot to turn her echo off the last time we spoke.
Oh.
I heard the two of you talking. Her echo went dead after the fighting started. I couldn't... What was she doing? Why did she lie to me? I need to know. I know she wasn't on a delivery job. Why would she lie to me like that? Why would she leave?
She was training me.
For what?
To be a vault hunter. She wasn't putting herself in danger for her own sake. She was teaching me how to survive.
She wouldn't do something like that out of the goodness of her heart.
An old friend of ours hired her.
Yeah? And where's he?
Oh, hell. Athena. So what happened to her exactly?
I've never seen Athena lose a fight. How'd she get grabbed?
So long as she's got that shield. I've never seen anyone so much as lay a finger on her. It doesn't make sense. She can't... Damn it. It took two Vault Hunters, and Valerie, and her entire gang just to take her down.
That's my girl.
Ha ha ha. This is kind of awkward. Change the subject. These nice ladies want us to build a rocket for them? What do you say?
I don't know if I've got the parts.
Sure you do. Come on. You just gotta...
I just want to know one last thing, and then I'll see about the rocket. Did she... say anything about me? Before they took her. The way she acted, sometimes I didn't even know if she liked me. Like maybe I was just a fluke or something. Hell, you don't need to hear this. Sorry.
She told me to pass on a message. She said she loves you.
She did? I... Oh, goodness. Okay. Oh, wow. Young lady, you are going to have yourself a rocket. And once I'm done building it, I'm going to grab every gun I can carry, I'm going to drive out of here, I'm going to rescue my girlfriend, and I'm going to marry the piss out of her. I'm in. I can probably build you something that'll break Atmo, but beyond that, you'll want a mechanic on board to make sure it doesn't explode on you.
Oh, man! That sounds like a job for the scooter man if I ever heard one. And considering it's a dream of mine to catch a ride into space and all that, it would be like just wow. What do you say, ladies?
Scooter, wanna come with?
Be our onboard mechanic?
You mean it? Woo, space buddies!
Here's how it's gonna go. The man with the plan right here is gonna track down the corpse.
Okay, I get it.
Off you go.
All right, Reese. Let's just find Vasquez's body, get back here, and not crap
crap our pants.
But you are gonna have such a hard on for my office, Reitz. It's, well, it's huge.
2 out of 3 ain't bad.
My office, not your hard on. Whatever.
Back here again. Thought I'd close the book on this weird chapter of my life.
Secret Atlas Communications Array. Manufacturer local artisan transfer speed 56 kilobits per second. Status really, really broken. I can see that. Shadowy silhouettes. Scary. Yes. Skags. Yes. Run. Yes. That's lovely. Power junction manufacturer Atlas, model the Zeus kilowatt, status beyond repair. The junction was never hooked up, hinting at plans for future secret Atlas facility expansion? Let's keep going. I'm gonna look at the things that I should not be looking at. Reese, can you walk any faster, seriously?
Yeah, you better run.
Well, I guess one of us ran. Uh-oh.
My office. Okay, dark interior, check. Planetary view, out the window, check. A chair so soft it could only be made out of supple kitten flesh, check. And if you're a good boy, maybe I'll even let you sit in it. Maybe.
Thanks. Corpse, species humanoid, characteristics swoopy hair, douche brows, back head fat, wallet head syndrome. Okay. Let's go poke at him then.
You see? I told you so. Wallet head.
All right, wallet head. Time to show your face back on Helios.
His face has no face.
Oh, you better hope a psycho didn't use it for a skin pizza.
A skin pizza? Oh god. What were the pepperonis? A skin pizza.
Oh, you clearly haven't been on Pandora long enough, compadre.
Let's find Vasquez's face. And get out of here.
You're the boss. All right, look, Reese. What happened between you and me, that's in the past, okay?
It's almost like it never happened.
Let's just drop it, okay? So we can focus on finding the face.
Okie dokie, I'll drop it like a moonshot into a basket full of puppies. No problemo.
You gotta keep an eye on your friends during this Helios mission, huh? Unlike how you're not keeping an eye on that tripwire.
What?
Well, looks like these psychos had themselves a little skin pizza party.
How am I gonna find Vasquez's face in all this mess?
That's what an Echo Eye's for, genius. Scan the faces from a nice stab-free distance. Unless you want to get up close and physical with some new psycho pals.
Psycho face ritual, medium, blood, quality art student, state school. This blood painting depicts the psycho face ritual colloquially known as the skin pizza. Marry the hyper-realistic portrayals of psychos celebrating their newfound face. Basically just says face on it, so. Anyway, got a couple we can already look at here.
Scanning.
Sleeping psycho, bed type. Flat tires, comfort index, horrendous back pain, chance of nightmares, 11 out of 10. Little known fact, psycho nightmares are actually beautiful dreams of puppies and friendly hugs. To them, however, this is terrifying.
You and me, Pumpkin, let's rock this walk. Whoa, this place is scaring me and I'm a frickin' hologram.
That's very reassuring, Jack.
Oof, disturbing.
Careful that now. Face wanna disturbing, end up psycho dinner. Disturbing.
Snooze and psycho?
I wasn't invited to this pizza party.
REM cycle low, wakefulness to almost, protocol, oh my god, please be quiet. Hint, shh. Okay, we'll try being quiet. Let's try not stepping on anyone. Hey, can you look at this guy? Yes.
Must have been one hell of a party.
You know, in a messed up way, I kind of respect this psycho. I always thought I'd drink or sex myself to death, too. Because those really are the two best options.
Shut up, Jack. Napping psycho type, catnap, dreaming of cats. Status, purring. Unless you're a cat, avoid the psycho at all costs. Actually, avoid even if you are a cat. Psychos are known to hug cats so hard they pop their little heads. That's lovely, I didn't want to know that. I'm sure not to step on this. Hey, actual pizza.
Disturbed huh? Sleep pattern?
Flawless!
Not now.
Interrupt.
All right, good, again, this time with feeling. Give him the old smack dab. Attaboy.
Need rest. Big day tomorrow. You die, I sleep.
Smacky dabby.
I should punch with this arm more often.
Okay, listen up, because I'm about to compliment you. No one ever became a leader without dirtying their hands. Oh, you're gonna get Hugo McSwoopy Hair's face back, no problem. Next stop, Hyperion, baby.
I'm not sure that was a compliment, but okay. And by the way, you can see that what I meant when I said Reese would take several episodes before he figured out that the robot arm was better for punching.
Huh. Kinda looks like my ex-girlfriend. I'd actually be okay with that. Sorry, Stacy.
Sombrero psycho loves hats and siestas, hates hatless and awake humans. This unconscious psycho knows how to party and avoid bad burns. Plus, sombreros just look badass.
Nope. Well, this is a fun night.
Chuggy McChugs a lot, formerly known as T2 Taylor. Psycho. Originally known as Designated Driver Psycho. The psycho may have had 100 too many. He may be blackout drunk, but he can still rip out your spine. That's nice. Vasquez's face. Original owner, Hugo Vasquez. New owner, Giggles. This face belongs to Hyperion's former senior vice president of security's propaganda. Stretches in the forehead's tissue reveal a history of facelifts. This, however, is the last one he will ever have. Not sure how he can do a facelift without a face, but...
Oh. Looks like we found our psycho.
You only see this kind of thing on Pandora. Get me back to Helios, Reese. Pretty please. With strippers on top.
Oof, that is one ugly mug. Where am I gonna put it?
Cram it in your pocket, I don't know.
I can't mess up his face or the Digistruct won't work.
Just rip it off like a bandage. Quick and painful.
Oh. Okay. Just peeling it off. Peeling off the face. Not going to barf into his mouth. With your mouth.
That's it. Go on. Peel off that face like a serial killer. You're sick.
Oh. No. Oh, it's stuck.
Oh, God, that's so... That is just the grossest thing I've ever seen.
Oh, God, I can't stop now. Oh, no. Are you kidding me right now?
Oh, pinch it off. Just pinch it off. Please.
Seriously? Oh, please don't do... Please don't do this to me. Oh,
smash the baby's face! Crunch its teeth!
Run! You're the only one running, pal! I can fly!
So, once I snatched that face pizza, gross, I sprinted out of Old Haven. Hundreds, no, thousands of psychos chased me.
Oh, really? That many?
Couldn't even count them all.
You were too busy trying to save face.
Okay, technically it was one psycho, but he had a bomb strapped to his chest that had the stopping power of like 1,000...
of... which could...
So, one.
One, yeah. Psycho. With chest bump. Boom.
You said something about a bomb, Psycho?
Oh. Yeah. There.
Whoa, wait, dude!
Oh, we were supposed to bring back the body.
Oh, we are still bringing it, babe. It's just gonna take a little longer to collect now.
Think I got some baggies in the truck.
It ain't pretty, but this one fits your budget.
Ugh, are Hyperion costumes necessary?
Fiona will fit right in with her spiffy new duds, but Sash, you look about as low-down Pandoran as they come. No offense, but if you want to be arrested within 10 seconds, be my guest. Hey, here's your disguise allowance. Don't think it'll be a regular thing or nothing. Get yourself something or get Sasha something nicer so she'll quit whining. Don't care either way. Just don't look Pandoran, or this mission will be over before it even started.
So, what are you gonna get, sis?
Close time.
All right,
again.
Let's see what we're working with. Hey, Fiona, the pricier option ain't too shabby. Plus, I kind of want you to spend all of August's money.
Hey.
Or whatever, just pick something that says, I look like a stuck-up jerk. Yeah, that'll work. All right, thanks, V. I'll try it on in a bit.
Hope it's worth the cash. Could have bought a lot of guns with that. You're up, Saj. Make it quick.
Huh, not bad. Makes me feel like I could drink the tears of a million dream-crushed orphans. I'll fit right in at Hyperion.
So, I'm sorry about earlier. I shouldn't have kept Jack a secret like that. It's kind of a weird thing to be dealing with. Not that that's an excuse. It's just what happened. And I wanted to say I'm sorry.
I'm not even gonna ask.
Yeah, it's probably better that way.
Hey, is this disguise gonna work? I figure you're the one with the eye for this. You and Vaughn are the only Hyperion I know, and you dress terrible. So maybe I should just take my chances.
It suits you.
Is that a pun?
Oh, no. That is hilarious, I get it. I'm just saying that it looks very convincing. It's a good look for you.
Thanks. But I'm gonna be burning these clothes once this is over.
Naturally.
Anyway, it's all yours.
Thanks. Just gotta scan my severed face here.
Yeah. Have fun with that.
Just get to the scan screen and...
Please scan skin.
Oh, there we go. Okay, skin scan.
Oh, God. Much worse from this side.
Skin unlocked.
Like, he just drops it on the floor.
That's convincing.
Is it?
Yeah, I mean, you look like a complete douchebag.
Excellent. That is the look I was going for.
This is... oh... definitely weird. Well, it's certainly big.
That's Scooter for ya.
I hope Vaughn's all right.
I'm sure Cassius is looking out for him. We'll track them down when we get back. Gotta see this.
Hey, you look like you've done that.
Like you've done that before.
I know it's where we're from, but it's never felt like home to me. I didn't think I'd ever see this. Guess you kept your promise.
I always do. At least, with you.
It looks so, I don't, peaceful. Who'd have thought? We haven't even gone that far, and it all feels a million miles away.
It's beautiful from up here.
From up here? Sure. It's a shame we have to go back. Wish we could just turn this thing towards the nearest planet. We'd probably run out of fuel, so it's not a good idea, but, you know, it's an idea.
One day we won't have to. We'll be able to pick whichever planet we want.
I can't wait. Ugh, I keep forgetting they're here.
Once we get the beacon, we'll figure out a way to turn things back in our favor.
Any ideas on how exactly we do that? Or are we just winging it. Again. I know we're good at improvising, but...
we wing it.
Of course we do.
When you're good at something, why stop?
Hey, watch it.
Oh, sorry, man. Just got a wife for me is all. It ain't bleeding or nothing.
What the hell is this damn thing?
It's, well, it's a satellite. Gonna launch it to advertise my franchise. You know what they say? Ain't no ad space like outer space.
Of all the brands, you picked the one Hyperion hates.
We're not drawing more attention to ourselves for some publicity stunt.
Hey, there's no need for that!
Stop it!
Come on, man! I gotta get some out of this trip!
You won't be alive to collect it if we get blown into dust.
Scooter's earned the right to cash in on this trip. If it weren't for him, we'd still be stuck down on Pandora. And August, what exactly have you done for this mission? That's what I thought.
Whatever.
Awesome!
That seems like a bad idea.
Well, no one asked you.
Warning! Debris collision imminent.
Is that a... person?
Shh. Looks like he's sleeping too.
Henderson.
Impact detected on center rocket booster.
No shit! Tell us something we don't know.
Did you know? The damage is critical.
So this is how I die. I knew it. I knew it!
Whose idea was it to bring this tin can?
We could really use your advice here.
This ship requires additional thrust.
Okay.
Without additional thrust, the ship will be pulled back towards Pandora.
Which is bad.
Pretty bad. Yeah.
Look, y'all, we need to do some compensating right here, and y'all are in luck, because that's my specialty. Now turn them other rockets up to 11. Oh yeah! Feel the burn! Oh man, I got like 50 lines I want to say about full thrust. It's like a junk log jam in my brain.
You ever stop, man? Serious.
No way, man. I'm just getting started. We got this.
Scooter, why is the whole ship shaking?
Nah, that's just because we're running real high right now. Like, kind of scary high.
What?
We gonna take it to the limit. Okay, we're about to hit escape velocity, and when we do, you gotta shut these puppies down, you hear?
Yeah, I hear.
Do you? How can you hear anything?
Achieving escape velocity in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Go!
So then, why are the alarms still going?
Now that was just step one. We can't do step two without step one.
Booster rocket failure imminent.
What does that mean?
They're going to explode.
Step two, let's do this!
When are they gonna explode?
Very soon.
What's step two?
We get out there and we handle these uncooperative rockets.
Oh, right.
Step three is us making out.
What?
Huh? What? Huh? Don't you worry your pretty little, all of you, yourself. I'll be walking you through it, though.
And those hood thingies are the ones they use in the pre-sequel. They basically create oxygen or something like that, I forget.
That's right. Easy does it.
But yeah. Physics, whatever.
Step two without step one, right?
No.
Guess my arms aren't quite as long as I thought.
Guys, that rocket's at critical. You gotta hurry.
No compensating on this one. I can't reach it. I tried, I really did, but it looks like it got me good.
No, I can pull you out.
Listen, there ain't nothing you can do that I ain't already tried, okay?
That's gonna be happening. What's going on out there?
Nothing. Don't you worry. Fiona's got this. Hey. You gotta go over there, pull that latch, and cut this rocket loose. There's no time for anything else, you understand? You gotta do it, or else the whole ship's gonna go.
No, stop, okay? There's gotta be some other way out of this.
No, there ain't. Even if there was, there's no time. This baby's gonna blow, okay? That is happening. And you can't be here when it does. Now, don't you go feeling all sorry for me, alright? People on Pandora will be talking about old Scooter for a long time. Can't think of a more epic way to go. Y'all should be so lucky.
Thank you, Scooter. Thank you.
Hey, I'm real glad to have met you, Fiona.
Right Rocket is way past critical, guys.
Oh, never mind, still going. My bad.
Alright, y'all. This is probably the end, but you see Moxie or Ellie, you tell them I did some awesome shit, okay? It's been real. All right.
That was the first casualty of the mission.
So, what did you do next?
What did we do? We honored him as best we could. He truly earned this. It's the least we can do.
Make it something good. It's the least we can do.
Like to lose someone you care about.
The worst part is, Scooter was the best of us. He deserves so much better.
He was definitely one of the nicest people I met on Pandora. Although that's not probably saying much. Anyway, we didn't have much time to mourn and all that. Things started to get crazy the minute we landed on Helios.